Hey there, my name is Jamie with Your Guide to Style, and today I want to talk to you about my top five outfit combinations for this fall season. You are going to see collages and a couple of outfits styled on my body because you guys have requested to see both of those, and I will also mention what body shapes go with these outfits. And I really don't mention age in this video because I really think these are very broad and can cover lots of different age groups and lots of different preferences. So since I don't think there are things that certain age groups should wear, I think that you should take these for whatever it is your preference is. So I always say wear what you love and what makes you feel good and what fits your body great. And so take these outfits not as specifics in the items, but as a combination of pieces that you can put together, and take your own pieces, your own preferences, and your own color preferences, and put them together and have a great stylish look for this fall. So that is my goal for you, to just take these and use them for what works for you. And also, thank you so much for leaving comments for me, for giving me suggestions. Please continue to do so. And thank you for hitting that subscribe button and the thumbs up. It really helps my channel grow. So let's go ahead and get into outfit number one. So outfit combination number one is the shacket and leggings, and then I'll show you a shacket and denim combination so you can see the versatility of this. But I really love the casual leisure style of the shacket with leggings. And in this outfit, I chose all black underneath, so a black legging, and then you could do a black t-shirt, but I chose a really cute hoodie that is a knit. It's more of a sweater, so if you want to layer and be warm, this is a good way to do it, or you could just do a plain black t-shirt. And do wear the shacket open kind of as a jacket. And then I just chose a great pair of fashion sneakers and a crossbody bag that you would wear across the body to keep with that sporty feel, and it is small. And so shapes for this, I really believe in leisure styles. You can pretty much any shape can do this outfit. You may want to adjust how long and how oversized the shacket is, but I do think in this leisure style, we're going more for cute maybe than super flattering. Although I think all black underneath it does make it a little bit more flattering for any body shape. So the next one I have is the shacket with jeans. And I do think that you can do skinny jeans, you can do slim straight. There's a slim straight here. I'll show you my favorite is skinny jeans, but this is actually really good because this shacket, I love this shacket. It's been hard to find them that actually come with a tie waist, but this one comes with a tie waist and it's great. It's from Target, it's inexpensive. There's two different colors. And this I think could go with a lot of different shapes if you wanna add a shacket, because it does cinch the waist and a lot of the shapes really call for trying to create a waist. And if you already have a waist, you really want to show off your curves, this would also work. So pretty much all shapes I think could do this. And you may want to adjust the jeans. If you have larger hips, you may want to wear a looser jean because you may not wear a slim straight anyway. So just think about that for the body shapes, but this combination with a slim straight would probably be best with rectangle, hourglass, and apple shapes. So this is me in my version of this outfit, which is a skinny jean, and I did add a little bit chunkier booty because I wanted to help balance my shoulders. I am a rectangle and inverted triangle, so if you're an inverted triangle, some of these shackets will add bulk to your top half, so just balance that with a little bit more bulk on your bottom half. That's how I like to have proportional balance. So outfit combination number two is an oversized blazer, graphic tee, and black jeans. And I wanted to mention black jeans because I think they are an awesome staple for your closet in the fall and winter. And with an oversized blazer of any color, because there's not even black in this blazer, but I loved it with black, and just a graphic tee that is fun. And I thought the combination was great just with a pair of sneakers and some fun earrings. And depending on how oversized you get your blazer, there are certain ones that don't look as great with the inverted triangle shape. I actually have this one and it looks best on me left open, because then my shoulders are not exaggerated since it goes straight down. So this would be great for rectangle shapes. This would be great for pear shapes. And if you wanted to add a straight leg to your pear shape instead of the skinny, then that would be good too. But I would totally put this on my sister-in-law, which is pear shaped. If you're apple shape, I do recommend you can also wear this, just wear a straight leg black jean, and you could actually wear this open and make sure you tuck the t-shirt in or tie it up, kind of create some separation there, and maybe wear the lighter gray with the black on the bottom, and that looks really good. Or you could even go black on black if you wanted to underneath that. So those are good combinations for you guys to just try for different body shapes. So outfit combination number three is hoodie, jackets, and straight jeans. And I love this sporty look. I chose this look to be a little bit monochromatic. So you have a lot of navy and gray going on here. And there is a little bit of white in that t-shirt, but it's layered underneath. So I think that gives it just a little bit extra oomph. But if you don't like you don't like the stripes on your body, just choose a solid color, even a gray, a white, or even a navy if you wanted to go full monochromatic. But this is a very classic look if you want something sporty and casual, leisurely looking. And I think shapes for this, the rectangle and hourglass shape is great if you are hourglass or even rectangle and you want to create a waist. Then you can wear the blazer closed. But if you are an inverted triangle, it's gonna look best left open because you don't wanna accentuate your wider shoulders because there's a lot going on the top half of the jacket. So the best thing to do is to wear it open. And if you don't wanna attract to your midsection, say for apple shapes with this, then you could wear a solid color tee if you don't like those stripes. And the jeans are a slim straight. You could wear a little bit looser straight leg, or you could even do a skinny depending on your body shape and your preferences. I am rectangle shape and I would totally wear a skinny jean with this, but I would wear a straight leg too. For people that are curvier, like an apple shape or a pear shape, you may even want to do, you could even do a little bit of a boot cut to give a little bit more fullness to the bottom half. So those are great options with that. I also love a hoodie jacket that's like this, that is a denim jacket. The photo I'm showing you is from another video I did on denim trends where this is denim on denim. But today I just have it on with my graphic tee, and I actually have biker shorts on doing this video, just to be honest with you. And I love this just styled with lots of different things. I throw it over my leisure wear. I throw it over my casual wear as I'm running out of the house. I've just enjoyed this jacket so much. So if you wanted to throw this on with just black jeans and a t-shirt and your sneakers, you are good to go if you will do that. Just choose the bottoms that fit more for your bottom half, like I have mentioned. So outfit combination number four is a sweater, dress, and knee-high boots. And I love this combination. Y'all, knee-high boots are so on trend for this season, and they look really good with sweater dresses, especially if they're shorter. You could throw on a pair of tights, and they look really good. With this dress, I think it is to the knee or maybe a little bit longer. So I still think the knee-high boot is okay. If you don't like the knee-high, just throw on a sock booty or something really cute. And then I just added a fun hobo bag and just a pendant necklace that's really simple to not take away from the dress. You could also add earrings if you wanted to. But with that neckline, I thought the shorter necklace was better than a longer one. And this outfit will take you lots of places. You could wear it to work. You could wear it out and about running errands if you wanted to just look extra cute if you were going somewhere that you needed to. You could go to meetings. You could go to church. You could go on a dinner date. Any of those things. So I think this is so versatile and great for the fall season. Shapes for this, since it is belted, I love the belted dresses. And if it doesn't come with a belt, belt it. And that looks really cute because belts are on trend this season too. But I love this for hourglass, rectangle, and pear shapes. Pear shapes, as long as it's not too fitted in the hips, you are good to go. So outfit combination number five is just stylish knit sets. And y'all, I love all the knit sets out there. You can find them for loungewear, leisure wear, casual, ones that you may want to just ultra layer with a cardigan, the undershirt, and the pants. And you could also dress them up a little bit. So I love the knit combinations. They are not all sweater knits. You are going to see a lot of sets that are maybe polyester and rayon, or You'll see different combinations, but I love all of the sets that are out there, just matching pieces, because they are very versatile in your wardrobe and you can break them up and wear them with other things. So with this, I just chose because I love these sweater sets, these knit sets, and this one is one of my favorites. It's got the polo sweater that I love with the collar, and then just the easy, leisurely pants that are knit. And I just put a pair of sneakers, a backpack, and some huggy earrings that are really simple with this because to me, this is very simplistic but looks very, very stylish. And I'm gonna do an elevated leisure video because I think this is definitely elevated leisure. And for body shapes, this will work for pear shape because it's got that wider leg and it will help balance the hips. And it also has the collar and the puff sleeve, so everything balances. The inverted triangle will look really good in this because of the balancing act as well. And then a rectangle because I'm rectangle and I would totally wear this. I might front tuck the sweater just to show a little bit of waist and give me a little bit more shape. And possibly any shapes could do this. So figure out what would work for your body shape. Maybe find a slimmer pant if you need a slimmer pant or even a longer, wider pant. I've seen flare leg ones, I've seen all kinds of different ones. So you can also find skirts and shorts and even dresses that are in combinations for this. So just so you know, those are out there. I wanted to show you this because this is one of my favorite combinations. So those are my top five outfit combinations for this fall season. I hope you guys enjoyed them. I hope they give you inspiration to create your own outfits with some things you have in your closet. I will link some things below. Anything you see in the photos that are available, I'll link for you and some other suggestions if you want to look at anything that you don't have that you just absolutely love. And there's various price points that come with all of these things. So I hope you will use these and create your own awesome outfits. And I also want to say all these outfits are in my online style guide, which is called Your Guide to Style. It's really cool. You can get outfit inspiration there. You can also shop straight from the app. And if you want to check it out, just go to our website at www.yourguidetostyle.com. And thank you guys so much for watching, and I will talk to you next time.